And a very good morning to you, Nigel. Look, you've got some very strong runners in on the program there at Avondale.
Yeah, morning, Swings.
Let's talk now as now in race number one. This is a horse that you gave a couple of runs through October and November, put aside, and look, the trial would give you a bit of confidence.
Yeah, look, she's. I've always had a bit of time for her. She's just taken a while to sort of mature. Yeah, she's very forward, but it's going to be interesting to see what the pattern is here today with the rail out 8 metres. And the only thing that worries me, there's a lot of speed in the race. I'm just worried she just might get back a little bit, just a fraction too far, you know, but I'm sure she'll be running on till the finish.
Okay, we've shown the trial recently, and it's a trial that says to me this horse is willing to put in an effort for sure.
Yeah, she's a lovely progressive filly, and I think, I think she's one that could work her way through the grades, you know, next campaign.
Race number four is a 65-12. You've got McCushley here. Kellum's doing the riding, and he was aboard when it was a very strong winner at Ellerslie. So this horse is obviously going the right way, and you get the 1,200 metres today.
Yeah, definitely. And I don't think she'll have any problem with the 1,200 metres. You know, she'll race on the speed. She's drawn out wide, so she'll go forwards from out there. You know, and I think she was very strong at the line at Ellerslie, so it definitely improved with the run. So, yeah, she's a nice progressive filly.
Okay, 1,200 metres. Everything suggests to me that you'll be taking your time and maybe getting over a bit further as we progress.
Yeah, well, look, I mean, she shows natural speed. She always has. But I mean, look, we'll be stepping her up from the 880 to the 1200, and we'll see how she copes. And you know, if she looks like she's going to go a little bit further, we'll look for options further down the track.
Race number five, you've got three horses here. Let's first talk Lupulani. There's not a lot to say apart from the horses going outstandingly at the moment.
Yeah, look, Lupulani's just so honest, Sween. She. You know, every time we take her to the races, she puts 110% effort in. You know, she's very tractable, so we can put claimers on her. You know, she goes well for anybody that rides her, so she's as honest as they come. Demonetisation, he's the class horse in the race, without a doubt. He had a setback in Brisbane last year, got a sort of a lung infection, and it sort of curtailed his campaign over there. But he was good at the trials the other day, and he's really improved with that. Whether he can, lump the 62.5 kilos against some of the other horses is yet to be seen. But he'll be hitting the line nicely.
Okay, are we leading towards demonetisation?
No, I think at the weights, we'd probably be leaning towards Gorgeous Geisha with the, especially if they're leading, if they're winning off the front today. We'd have to lean towards her because she's only got 51 kilos on the back. The speedy horse on the speed, lightweight, fit horse, loves the track. Loves the wet track. She'll be take a bit of catching, I think.
Okay, moving on into race number six, we've got Diogenes. All the form in the north at the present moment is based around this horse. If you've been close up to Diogenes in those two runs, then you've been a pretty strong winning chance when you've lined up next.
Yeah, well, look, he's one that's sort of, if you look at what he's racing against now compared to what he was racing against two starts back, he's certainly stepped up in the grades. But, look, he's a fit horse. He loves the wet track. Once again, that 4 kilo claim with Callum's is going to be gone. He'll race on the speed, so... Yeah, look, he's a horse in good form.
Well, you got right to the outside fence and took the best part of the running. Is that the question mark here? Like, you're just going to have to tell Callum through the day to find where the best part of the running and just observe patterns that are going to sort of develop there at Avondale?
Yeah, well, that's right. I mean, we're going to know pretty much after the first couple of races where the right place to be is. So we'll just work that out as the day goes on.
Okay, and into race number nine, you've got Ruzik. Andrew Cord is doing the riding here. It's been 9 lengths fresh up this time in at Counties. The improvement there that is required?
Yes, look, her right Counties was probably better than it looked. She was just a little bit slow away and she had an inside draw. And, where she was in the running, Andrew just couldn't get her out into that fast lane up against the outside fence. But she still made ground in the worst part of the track. Stepping up to the mile would be right, in her favour. And we put the blinkers on her today just to try and sort of sharpen her up. So if you know, if the blinkers work and she gets the right run, you know, she's got to be right in amongst it.
Okay, there are good chances across the program. Which one should the bookmakers be most scared about?
Oh, look, I think probably Gorgeous Geisha. I mean, I know that she loves a wet track and she's, you know, she's very well. You know, no weight on her back. I think she gets into that race exceptionally well.
Okay, Nigel, thank you very much for your time and best of luck with your runners this afternoon.
That's great. Thanks, Brendan. My pleasure, mate. Bye.
Booker runners there at Avondale for Nigel now is now race 1, Makushla race 4, Lupulani race 5, Demonetisation, Gorgeous Geisha, and that is the one that he's suggesting is the best amongst them. Diogenes in race number 6 and Ruzik, who's also short in race number 9. They have put out a special option here on the Nigel Tiley runners. One win 260, two 250, three wins 460, four more wins 17, and if he gets none, he'll be blaming me as a curse. It's $7.50. Let's hope not.